Well, I would say that as difficult as it was, the excitement of getting to this point, where now the overwhelming majority of the Ghanaian Premier clubs and Division One clubs have shown up to participate in this tournament. You cannot call yourself a football nation and there is no football being played. You saw the enormity of the fans to support the Black Stars. You saw when Kotoko was playing at the Kumasi Sports Stadium. So I think the evidence that Ghanaians love football is clear. And therefore, I think the clubs coming now to start playing football, if we do things right, the refereeing is good, the fans go to the stadium, then the continuation of the development of Ghana football will be on the right track.
So someone would ask, how important is this competition to an organization committee?
Oh, it's important in the sense that we want to test some of the solutions to the problems that we have identified. You know, they say the proof of the pudding is in the eating. You will never know if what you're thinking is right. But when you put into practice, that if I do media hype better in a consistent way, the fans will be excited and they'll go and watch the matches. So we'll see the fans go there. You know what I'm saying? And then we are the biggest problem facing Ghana football is revenue. Revenue into football that goes to the clubs, that will then strengthen the clubs to be able to pay their players well. So a lot of our players will not be dreaming about leaving Ghana and that they can stay here and make a good living. It is very important. It's also about developing our country and creating jobs for our young people. If every young person who is interested in football dreams about leaving Ghana, then that is not something acceptable.
Okay, interestingly, you've mentioned some of the problems that have engulfed football in the country. One of the key things that we saw in the announced expose was about 77 referees found to be manipulating the outcome of matches. Some of us have always said, the enemy of Ghana football is referees' integrity. How sustainable is this for Ghana football?
Well, you are putting your finger on a very crucial matter with the game of football. If there is no integrity that the better club will win on the field of play by being the better club, but they are going to win through the shenanigans of some referee, you are gradually going to kill the game because the fans are not stupid. You give a wrong penalty, you continue to do that, eventually they will support. They will stop supporting you. So I think integrity of refereeing is critical. And that's why we brought the FIFA people here to take our selected referees through integrity training. A 4 or 5 day training alone cannot solve the problem. But I think all of us as Ghanaian citizens must realize that whatever part we are playing in the football enterprise, we have to be honest in what we are doing. And the game, for instance, you are a journalist. You have to be honest in what you're doing to make you succeed. So apart from training them, we've tried to create an emotional umbilical cord between themselves and honesty. And hopefully this will sink in and their day-to-day practice of their profession will be improved.
My final question will have to do with the special competition instead of the continuity of the Premier League. Most Premier League clubs say, or most clubs say, they invested so much in the first round of the league they partake, but it has been curtailed for a special competition, and this competition will not qualify them to play in the Premier League. Why choose the special competition instead of the continuity of the Premier League?
Well, my brother, you know we are in normalization times, okay? This is not normal times. And therefore, when you are in abnormal times, you try to do things that will fit. For instance, every competition you want to embark on needs some kind of money. And the normal football enterprise, the money should come from sponsorship, from broadcast rights, from merchandising revenue, from match day ticket sales. But because our game has gone down, all these revenue lines have dried up. So you have to do what you can do with the money that is available to you. And I think we are very grateful, as we said, to the government of Ghana for seeing that they have to be the catalyst to regenerate Ghana football because no sponsor was willing to come in. And so if we do this thing right, then the sponsors will see that, hey, football is now a big platform for me to advertise myself, like in every country that is a great football country. Once we get there, more money will come into football and we can do this better.
Thank you very much, Doctor.